WD. And today, I'm going to give you a quick overview of Ethereum test. What is blockchain? In the blockchain, we have one state and some transition rules from one state to another. Those states are represented by blocks. And transition rules are basically a protocol. In case of Ethereum, these are the rules for calculating next difficulty, gas limit, and other parameters of Ethereum. And the question is, how would we come to consensus in case of different clients' implementation on the different languages? All of them should come to exactly the same state and be in consensus with each other. And to do that, we created tests. Tests represent transition from one state to another. And they're divided. There are the most major ones used: blockchain tests, transaction, state, VM. And we created thousands of such tests. And I begin with the more simple tests. It's state test. Most common example. They are encoded in JSON files. You could see the link down below to the test repository. To the document. And in such JSON tests, there is a most important part is a post state that would be created by the client while creating an environment with some pre-state and the transaction that would be executed in this pre-state. And the client should create such environment by executing this test and execute a transaction and get their own post state. Then they compare this post state to the ones that describe it in test file. Blockchain tests are basically like state test, but in this test you have not a single transaction, but a series of blocks. And each block could have different transactions. Some blocks might be invalid, and each client should read such test from a JSON and try to import it in its own blockchain. And as a result, it also gets a post state and last block hash. So these are important values. Clients check such values against the ones that described in the tests. This is example of invalid blocks. They're represented by empty RLP bytecode. And as you could compare, a valid block have different parameters that are also encoded into RLP. So what clients should do, they read such blocks from a test file, decode RLP function, and compare parameters of a block to the one described in a test file. That's for valid blocks. And for invalid blocks, we have just RLP. That means that such blocks should be considered invalid. If a client considers such block valid, then something is wrong. And a lot of questions was to the blockchain test folders that are also in our GitHub repository. We have blockchain test folder with subfolders for homestead folder and the test network. And now I will answer your questions about how test and the, how test working in such folders. So in blockchain test folder, we have tests that have blocks that are from frontier network only. And in a homestead subfolder, all blocks starting from zero and so on are from homestead rules. And the test network is a special one because in such network, we have like 8-10 blocks in one test file. And starting from 5 blocks, there are homestead rule applied. And then recently added from block 8, DAO hard fork should occur, and we have such tests to test the DAO for transition, and maybe we would have another addition to these rules for test network. And you can find on the link down below, there's a documentation about such tests. Like the state test, we have VM tests. Basically the same, but the sole purpose is to test the VM. And it basically executes a code for VM, not concerning about blockchain properties or something. And next, we have more simple tests, like transaction tests. Just describe how transactions should be imported or whether it could be recognized as a wrong LP for wrong transaction. So in a JSON file, we have this description where the block number indicates whether this is a transaction from frontier network or homestead. And other values are also present if a transaction is valid. If transaction is not valid, also you have just LP field. That means the transaction is invalid, and you, when you're implementing such tests in your client, you should check against this. And how these tests are created? We're creating source tests through the CPP client, special test tool called TestEat. And for each test, for most of them, we have test filler file. This file, like a source code for the test, TestEat executes on such a file and creating a destination test. This was originally designed by Christoph Jensch. And now we have like all tests working the same. But sometimes I have a request to the Ethereum test repository to add some more tests. And this is not really a correct way to add some, because these tests are going to be recreated by these test fillers. So if you want to add a new test case, you first want to experience what are the test fillers. Or basically just open an issue for the test repository, not the test. So what do we have? We have documentation and help created by Bob Somerville on this Ethereum doc site. Here is a link for the tests. We have test repository containing thousands of tests in a JSON file. And recently we started a new project like Hive implementation, in which you just provide your client executable and the bash script to run inside Hive. And Hive would be the test framework that would execute different kind of tests on your client. And all you have to do is just to provide your client setup or deployment script and RPC IP for your client. And we also have a GitHub channel where you could ask questions for concerning development and testing. You could find me there. So basically, that's a quick overview of our testing the Ethereum clients. Thank you.
Thank you, Dimitry.